moves. Moves like Jagger. Ça passe nebolé. Seen a cock geezu dude do the thing? Oh. You ever seen him do that? It won't do it. It's okay. It's okay. Yo, Rich, I try to catch you. Hey, Rich. Yo, you had a prep already, Rich? God damn. Welcome to the Fat Joe Show. God damn, Rich playing it gone. Unbelievable. He's huffing and puffing. He's huffing and puffing, blowing that house down. James Crews on the check and Richard Campbell on the check in. Everybody laughing at you. Ciroc, a much finer vodka. F-A-N-M-I-O, if you want to connect with your favorite artist. You're a gamer, Cousin Miriam. You're a gamer, GameStar app. Play against your favorite celebrity. Natina, get the hell out of my bedroom. Natina is texting from there. Maxi, Maxa, Maka, Makusa, Amakazi, Mako. Get it? The Big Show is back. Executive producer Azariah Milan, Cartagena. I am Guy Wood, aka 5001 Flavors. Tone Sunshine. Yo, Guy 5001, I got a bill with you. Let T Lover know he's in here. He can collect your cash for you. DJ Entice, what's good? What's up, my people? How you doing? I'm so happy to see you guys, man. You know, it's always an honor to talk that shit with y'all, man. Know what I'm saying? And so much to talk about. Basketball season. Well, tonight, right after this, you got No Limit Chronicles. On BET at 9 o'clock. Tomorrow night, we back in business, baby. Tomorrow night, we got NBA basketball. Shout out to my brother, my twin brother, Raul T.S. Conde, one of my top five dead or alive since day one. I love you, Raul. I can't tell you any way much more how much I love you, my brother. You know, some crazy shit happened yesterday. I was watching. And I don't want you to take this the wrong way. Right? Yo, Dre, what's up? What time the Knicks play? Okay, Jay. Okay, Dre, you got... Dang. You got jokes, Dre. Explain something to you. And I'm not trying to throw up mixed signals or mixed vibes. But I was watching something on the internet yesterday where they had this woman, she's a doctor, started in Nigeria, and came over here, she's in Houston. And she said she dealt with malaria in Nigeria and infectious diseases, and she gave this thing called hydrochloroquine, whatever that is. You know, the drug they keep saying Trump takes as a prevention. So, you know, I'm a CNNer. You know, I watch the same news you watch. And they keep shooting down this drug. They keep saying this drug is the worst. It might give you a heart attack. You're done. Don't use this. Don't listen to Trump. They're laughing at him. So they got me laughing at him and Zinc. So I'm like, ha ha ha, you know, laughing. This woman goes up there who's a doctor. And Pretty Lil, what's up? Woman goes in there. She's a doctor in Washington with like 100 doctors behind her. And she says, hey, I use this hydrochloroquine for the malaria in Nigeria. And I'd seen over 350 patients with COVID in Houston, Texas. And she says, diabetes, 92 years old, 87 years old, asthma, all type of underlying conditions. And nobody died. And so, you don't believe it. See, but here's the problem. You know, I make a direct correlation with Tupac. When Tupac died, people were saying, yo, he's in Cuba, some shit like that. But I seen the press conference with the doctors. So you get the head of the hospital and all that. These people went to school for 14, 16 years to be doctors. They're not gonna lose their credibility to say Tupac's dead and he's in Cuba. Same thing, this lady ain't going to Washington, D.C. to say, she ain't going to Washington, D.C. to say that hydrochloroquine saved 350 people. So now I get confused because the media I love to watch is telling me,
Joey,
what's
back
up, my brother?
How are you, man?
Talk to me. What's your name? Where you from? Where you at?
Right now, I'm in the hospital. We spoke before. We chopped it up before, and we got cut off, but we couldn't get back. My name's Harry, and I'm in San Jose right now. I won't say what facility because you're famous, and I ain't trying to break the back.
Don't do that. So what's going on out there with the COVID?
Right now, we're seeing a second, like a surge. So the numbers are going up.
Numbers are going up. Are you treating them with hydrochloroquine and zinc?
Not here. The only thing that I've heard here is remdesivir. And it's like seven doses that they put them on. And I have a couple of different perspectives on this. Now, this situation is a little special because if you look at the stock market and you look at all the different pharmaceutical companies that are creating testing kits, different treatments, which are therapies, and all the ones that are chasing this vaccine for that, you know, for COVID.
Why you go like this? Why you go like that? For that?
Because it's a money grab. It's a quick money grab. Any company that says, hey, we're doing COVID, we're chasing COVID, their stock goes up through the roof. Like, you know what I'm saying? So there's a lot going on. And another thing that's kind of crazy is that a lot of these big companies that have lobbyists, they got connections with, you know, people in government, politicians. They're on the forefront. So there's a lot of small companies that may have therapies, they may have different treatments and ideas. They get pushed to the back because they don't got the bread to get that type of plug. You understand? So it seems to me that there may be some things out there that could work, but they're not going to get looked at.
Did you see this woman doctor who went in Washington, D.C. yesterday with like 100 doctors behind her and talked about she gives hydrochloroquine, the zinc, right, and something else. And 350 people are still alive with diabetes,
right,
with everything.
Right.
Do you think a doctor get up there nationally and lie to the people?
No, because that's that's verifiable. You can verify that. There's medical records. That's easy.
And so let me ask you something. If she's saying that people come with diabetes,
right,
all type of illness, and every single one of them live, why we're not using these medicines that she's talking about?
Because, see, that's what I was. I wanted to kind of steer the conversation.
Now tell me why. No, but tell me why we're not using that.
Now, there's a couple reasons. One, it's political. You know what I'm saying? It's a political agenda. Right. And that's why I'm saying there's certain companies and certain people, they get the first plug. You know what I'm saying? It's almost like, Jamie, what's up? Yeah, I'm good. So it's like contacts. It's like connects. You know what I mean? Let's say you got to connect with the DJ. That's your man. Yo, you got a record. Your record playing first. He don't know me. I'm like, yo, I got a record too. He said, get in the back of the line. Now, we dealing with a very controversial election coming up. If Trump says this thing right here, bro, the machine is going to be like, nah, we not, we not doing that. Now, this is just, for me, this is just common sense. If someone says, I got the cure and I helped solve 350,000 cases, let's see if it's true. Go into the medical records and let's verify it. Is it true or not? Simple. This is not hard. Like, if you had a kid that had COVID, wouldn't you want to know the truth? Can this help my child? Don't you want to know? But no, they pulling up freaking her religious beliefs and all of that. I could care less what she believes. I don't care about that.
What does she believe?
You know, they pulled out some video of her talking about, like, you know, spiritual stuff, like masturbation and things like that. They talk about alien DNA, all this craziness. And that's fun.
The same lady saying that?
Yeah, same lady saying that. Same lady saying that.
Y'all same can't lady. Fuck with her then.
But see, this is the thing. This is, it doesn't matter what she said at the church one day. I want to know, is this true?
Did she save the 350 people?
Period. That's all we want to know. You don't care what, do you ask the doctor to help you?
Will you do me a favor, being that you're a friend to the show? Can you come back tomorrow and have the data, the proof for us?
Oh, no. Those are medical records, and it's a HIPAA violation. I wouldn't even be able to find those records. Those things are under lock. But she has the power to reach out to those people, to get them to sign over disclosure agreements, have private firms investigate. This is not hard, bro. It's not. We talk about the government and a pandemic and the United States is shut down.
I know, but once you start talking about aliens, DNA, and this and that, that sounds like wacko jacko to me. Like, I'm so, keeping it real.
I feel you.
Straight up doctor.
She is, though. She is a doctor. There's no question. She's a doctor. Let me ask you a question.
She's a real doctor.
Yeah, of course she's a doctor. Now, this is the real thing. Let me ask you this. You're a doctor. Do you know what he believes? His spiritual beliefs?
No.
Do you care?
Yeah, I do if he believes in the aliens and and Satan and shit like that.
Let me just ask you. So if you get sick and you find out that he believes in whatever he believes, so you're not going to go to him because of that? And I don't blame you if you don't, but I'm just saying.
Yeah, no, I can't fuck with it like that. That's not on.
For real?
No, wow. I'm keeping it real. Like, you can't tell me, yo, Joe, you seen that alien? And you, yo, Satan's around the corner and take this medicine. I'm like, no, fuck no. Like, yo, nut job. Like, fuck out of here, man. My brother, I'll holler at you because I got some other guests on here.
No doubt. Blessings to you, brother.
Nothing but love. Stay up, man.
Love. Peace.
I don't know. I thought it was some real shit. But when they start telling me that the woman crazy and all that, a fucking nut job, She had me at hello. I was falling for this shit. These people are crazy, man. I don't, you see, you don't know what the fuck to believe.
Yo, Joe.
Duma, my African brother.
What's going on? What's
oh,
up?
Man? Oh, wow.
That's right.
Yo, Tuma.
What's up?
This woman, she had me believing it.
Yeah, it looks like she's part of one of those kind of conspiracy theorist type of groups. Because she's mixing up a whole bunch of, like, spiritualism, like having gynecological stuff mixing up with, I think, spirit. Wives and spirit husbands came and had sexual contact, and that's why you have these gynecological issues, etc. She's being used basically by the Trump type supporters. You know, she's not.
Wow, but legit, it's done it. So you don't believe that she saved 350 people?
No. I don't believe that at all. And I wouldn't be surprised if she gets investigated and her medical license gets investigated. I don't.
You think she could get up there and lie about that?
If she's getting paid enough, or if she actually believes all that stuff that she's doing. Also, you have to remember something else is there's a lot of people who believe in like witchcraft and you know. Etc. There's nothing stopping them from getting a formal education, you know? I used to hear those stories growing up about cats turning into jars of Vaseline and fires hopping, and they used to have these ghosts called Tokolosh, right? They used to say, Tokolosh, come in your house. In Africa, that's common. And also, traditional healers have a lot of power, and people who grow up believing this stuff really, like, you know what I mean? Like, take this shit seriously. And so she's just mixing it. She's just mixing the, in my opinion. All that stuff was removed from a lot of platforms because it was missing.
Well, you know, you never lied to me in your life. Shout out to Noriega. Shout out to Timberland on this. You got to stop. Yo, Nori, you got to stop. Yo, too much.
All right.
Tell them who you are, man. Tell them about YouTube. Tell them you the man, not the myth.
I'm Tuma Bassa. I've known Joe for over 20 years from when I was at BET. Let me tell you some Joe stories, a few Joe stories. He was on Atlantic at that time, but when we moved to New York from DC to New York, and he basically took in Kelly G, myself, Stephen Hill, and Joe was, when he said, calls himself the Don. He was really the Don. Like, he didn't have to say a word. Things would just happen. He didn't have to say nothing. That was the real, you know what I mean? So he was that plug, that connect. So he basically took us in, and we hit Jimmy's Uptown Cafe, Jimmy's Bronx Cafe. I remember we went to dinner, like, this is like, right when we arrived, it was like a Cuban spot, and I think it was Habana. Thing, you know, Joe just is like this. So and then also Joe's the A&R. He used to always call a lot of records saying that's a hit, and I'm like, nah, it's not a hit, and it would be a hit.
Yo,
we have many stories like that. So I humble myself. So you know, so that's BET, MTV, Revolt, Spotify. Like there's been constant realness. And
you know the Fat Joe show going to be on Revolt.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, that means you're going to be on YouTube.
I guess YouTube. I mean, me and Diddy worked out a deal. We're going to have it on Revolt.
Oh.
It goes down, I think, like August 4th. Shout out to Noriega on the check-in.
Oh, that's amazing. I didn't even know that. That's amazing.
You know, things are moving. Things are shaking. Things are growing. What do you want me to do? You know what I'm saying?
No, you have to. You have to grow. Go with the. I call it surfing. You know what I mean? Like you pay attention to all the different kinds of waves and you surf accordingly. You know, et cetera, et cetera.
Who's the African? Because to me, you're the Don of the Africans.
No, I'm a spokesperson. I'm a spokesperson. I'm a spokesperson.
No. You're the most humblest Don, but you're the Don of this shit. Nobody bigger than you, Tuma. What I'm asking you is give me the top three. Well, give me five. Give me your top five African artists.
Okay, I can't do it in any particular order.
No, don't do it in any order.
Okay, no particular order. Right now, it's Burna Boy, Davido, Wizkid. I want to put Black Coffee from South Africa in there, right? Only because he has a huge international appeal. And then I would also put a guy named Diamond Platnumz from Tanzania. Oh, Aya Nakamura. In French-speaking Africa, Aya Nakamura. But right now, we just talk about the English-speaking, like Nigeria, South Africa.
I love Tanzania. Hey, yo, yeah. Common, what's up? Yo, Common, we need you on the biggest show in the game.
Common sense. Both of you guys are relativity.
I used to call common sense relativity with me.
Yeah.
But everybody look at me like I'm crazy.
Have you ever seen the footage? There's some footage. Roth McDaniels has it. It's basically, it's Biggie and Nas on stage doing Goodfellas. Remember, they only performed it once. The song never came out. You and Common, you guys want relatively common sense, were right there, right in front. I think, right there. This is like Flojo era Fat Joe.
Yeah, we was downstage while they freestyled together. It's the only time, thank you, Common. It's the only time Nas and Biggie ever shared the stage together like that.
Yeah,
I was in the crowd, me and Common.
Yeah, Rob McDaniels has the footage. I've seen the footage. He showed me the footage. It's the only time ever we've ever seen. Because remember, Nas and Biggie had a falling out after that, so we never saw them together.
You know, this guy, Rob McDaniels, he's waiting till I die so he can sell the footage. He got too much footage of Fat Joe.
No, Rob McDaniels, the Museum of Congress or whatever, the Library of Congress or African American Museum, somebody needs to do a deal with Rob McDaniels. He's the institutional memory of New York hip hop.
He's still going right now. Video music. I watch it every night. I've been in New York.
He's still going up to today. Yeah.
But
he doesn't get the credit. You know what I mean? Like he has all of this, and he's been doing this off of love. The fact that he's still up to today, 30 something years later, he was pre Yo MTV Raps, and he's post. The fact that he's still doing it is everything. You know, and he needs that credit. Yeah.
Tuma, I love you. I thank you for checking in with us.
Thank you. All right. Love.
You know me, my brother. I love you like for everything. You know what I'm saying?
No, I love you. It's mutual. Like the double fold. Triple
tell your
fold.
Wife I said what's up.
She's right here. She's not camera ready, but she's
tell her the only woman that had 17 weddings. you went and got married in every country in Africa. Every tradition in the world.
COVID messed it up.
Yeah, exactly.
Y'all gonna go more?
Yeah.
All right, Tuma.
All right, thank you, Joe. All right, love you too. All right.
You don't know who I know. African Connect right there, boy. That's Tuma. He runs YouTube. He started Rap Caviar in Spotify, personally. He was the first guy to work at Revolt. And there he left MTV, but started in BET. And like I said, or well, he said, I welcomed him with open arms to the hip hop community. In New York City. You don't know who I know. Will Castro, I seen you in here. Common, I'll get the Common. I get Common is a whole separate segment by himself. Oh yeah, I'm gonna go live with some people too. I'm looking for Will Unique. He want to talk. Yo, Pretty Low. Pretty Low, how many more weeks we got? Yeah, I would never do politics, guys. I can't do politics. If I did politics, I'd be dead in a week. Cannot do politics. I'm from the Bronx, New York. Shit happens. I love Tanzania. Dar es Salaam. Yeah, Jay. Jay, you can't play both sides of the fence. Jay saying that the Billy said, Billy meaning billionaire, said hydrocortisones work for him. Who the fuck do we believe? I seen remdesivir. I know that really works. This is, I don't know what to tell you guys. I don't see no. Will Castro said he wanted to come on. I'll take somebody. Unique Auto. I don't see you, brother.
Yo, Joe.
Yo, Jay.
I'm not playing both sides.
Yo, cortisone work with the zinc.
First of all, it's hydroxychloroquine. Let's get it right. Listen, this is your friend that you introduced me to. Your good friend, the nicest man in the world, that you did a song for him, wrote the song for him and his wife that he performed for his wife. The nicest man in the world.
Sean had it. The family had it.
He said the hydroxy with the zinc saved his life and his whole family's life. I couldn't believe it because I watch MSNBC like you, CNN. They keep shutting it down. Then when I seen the black lady put it on, I was like, damn, that's crazy. But then I got the text from your friend, and he said, guys, you know, just being a good guy, like, yo, you know, he sends the text to the inner circle, friends, whatnot. Listen, we just got over the theory. Here is the step-by-step for you to prevent it. What happens if you get it? And this is what you need to do. Step two, if you get it, take the hydroxy with the zinc immediately. It saved my life. And I was like, you know what? You know, these guys know something we don't know.
Well, you know that lady talking about voodoo and fucking aliens and
the doctor, the black nurse, the black doctor that you had on earlier, he's been on your show before. Yeah. He said the realest shit in the world. He said, well, you know, maybe they don't want Trump to be the guy to introduce the theory. Maybe they don't want. Of course, we're not with him. Yo, Joe, the reason we got it is because of him. He's the reason.
Let me ask you a question, Jason. You telling me, God forbid I get COVID-19, I better ask for that hydrocortisone?
I would call Sean. I would call Sean. It's real, Joe.
Yo, Jay,
you're in New York, we're safe.
Jay. I know you're a part of a classic album, Family Ties.
It's a classic.
I know you've been a father lately, my beautiful niece, Marley.
I love it.
She's love gorgeous. It.
Thank you so much.
We call her the giant baby.
Yes, Drake, she's tall.
Every morning and she floats like in the Thanksgiving Day parade. So she's a giant baby because Drake tall as hell. So she comes floating. So I call her the giant baby.
She's the size of a two-year-old. She's only 8 months.
Yo, that's crazy. Hey, yo, Jay, let me tell you something. And she sings like Mariah Carey.
I got it. I'm going to post tomorrow. She's hitting all the notes. Remember, I got me feeling emotions. And then Mariah started hitting them. She's hitting those notes.
Yo, Jay, she's...
I introduced her to Biggie today. Jay. I started playing her some B.I.G.
Being that we spent so much money on the Family Ties album and getting you to where everybody knows you and loves you? Are we ever going to be able to make a dollar off you and put out the Dre album?
Well, Joe, the greatest thing about this life is that we love to make music so much. We're so blessed to have a talent to go into the studio, you and me, write our lyrics, perform our lyrics, make our beats, press play, hear our voice, shoot videos, see our face performing these lyrics. You know, it's not a gimmick what we do. We're so blessed. Yes, I want to drop the album this year. It's tough, Joe, because we got a pandemic, and I feel like I've been working on this album for 10 years. Joe, you know me since I was a kid. This is an important album. I don't want to put it out there without everything being lined up. You know what I'm saying? I will say this.
We're not making no money.
No, Joe. It's, listen, Joe, we love music, Joe. You look at what you're looking around.
Y'all got it.
Joe, of
course. You don't want to make a buck. I can't make a buck off this guy. Let me tell you something. This guy, Dre, this guy, Khaled, Cool, they refuse to let me make a buck. Remy, nobody, Big Pun never let me make a buck. Nobody wants me to make a dollar. Why?
Patience is such a gift and a talent from the Lord above, Joe. You got it. Remain patient. Say,
thank you for my last year's present, you and Cool. Y'all bought me a masterpiece.
You're welcome.
Well, that's an expensive Rolex, and I love them. My brothers anyway, no matter what they get me or not. Yo, Dre, basketball season? No, I don't even want to ask you that.
No. Ask. Yo, listen. Tom Thibodeau's a nice pick. No. Tom Thibodeau's a nice coach for the New York Knicks. I like him. I know it's not Mark Jackson, but he's still a nice, coach. He's still a nice coach. But listen.
They're not going to win until they get Mark Jackson.
The sleeper on the East this year is the Miami Heat. We all know that. You know what I'm saying? We have a super nice squad. We got Bam, who should be the most improved player. He should win that award. You got Jimmy Butler, who's leading the team. His leadership skills and talents are just, it's like he's like a military captain.
He wears see-through shirts with his nipples showing.
Listen.
I've seen the guy myself. He wears fishnet shirts with his nipples showing walking down the street in Miami. I've seen him myself, Dre.
Yo, Jimmy Butler, if you're tuned in, this is just Joe's way of saying he got love. That's
he
it.
What's my man, Jason? Jason went with us to Essence Fest. What's Jason the makeup
Yo, chill, Joe.
With
you
his
gotta
nipples
stop.
Showing.
You gotta stop. Listen, just stop. We got Tyler Hero. We got Duncan. We got Andre Iguodala with his championship pedigree and experience to bring to the team. We got the Dragon at the point. We got that kid Nunn at the point who's nice.
Eric,
we got some dogs.
Boston Yonder.
Boston is a serious threat. Boston is a threat. You know what I'm saying? The Clippers and the Lakers.
Been on the check and happy birthday to Cav. Hey, yo, my brother, I love you.
I love you.
Stay
too.
Up.
I will. Hit me after the show.
Sure. I get my hand on the hydrocortisone shit.
It's hydroxychloroquine. And listen, everybody that's
tuned.
Yes, everyone that's tuning into the Fat Joe Show, I want to tell y'all this. Soak up all the game this guy's giving you, man. Don't get comfortable just seeing him every day. That's what happens when you're with Joe. You get comfortable. You're like, yo, that's my man. And the jewels will go over your head. Don't let it happen. Always pay close attention to what this man is saying. Trust me. Trust me on this one. I love you, Joe.
I love you, Jay.
God bless.
The man showed his face so he could stick it to me because the Knicks ain't there. I know what he really did. Shout out all my brothers in Miami. You know, they've been killing me for years. Luce, Jen, I'm letting y'all know something. New York City on the check-in. These Knicks better make moves. If they do not make moves, we're going to have a huge problem. A huge problem. RIP Malik B from the Roots. Living legend, founder, I'm sorry, Philly. Malik B. From the Roots. It's the Fat Joe Show. Home of where we never jam you up. Where you come and you get love. You get celebrated. Embraced. Never dragged through the mud. I have no clue. Your man Will Unique is on. He's I swear to my mother, this guy, Will Unique is like, this guy is on here every day. He's on here every day. I am Will Castro, but I mean, I don't. He's not on here right now, guys. He's on every day.
Connected.
R.I.P. Malik B. Hello?
That's us. Oh, hi. Hi.
How you doing?
Good, good. We try to connect all the time, and we never do, so sorry.
Oh, man, I'm happy for you.
Sorry, we were cooking.
Yeah, yeah.
What you was cooking?
Pasta, and what are you making?
I'm making chickpeas and eggs. Plant-based.
Plant-based? So you are vegetarian, both of y'all?
No, we're just trying. We're trying.
That shit is nasty, healthy, bro. I can't do it. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm on a real diet. My real diet is I ain't been eating no carbs. I eat greens and I eat protein. I cannot do plant-based solely without a piece of chicken or fish or something.
We can't either.
I can't.
We try once a week.
We're doing once a week. One.
Oh, Ma, can we do once a week vegan?
Sure. But
that
Joe,
makes sense. This the fans. No, I'm not lying. On a Monday, let's do vegan Monday.
Yeah,
that's the way.
The longer the expiration date on something you eat, the shorter yours. You got to be careful what you put in your body.
I know, man. I have a problem. My problem is, so you know, I told my daughter the other day, I said, listen, she's the executive producer of the show. I said, listen, mama.
She's doing a good job, by the way.
Thank you. She got on me. She said, Dad, you drink too many Diet Pepsis, too many Diet Snapples. She's right, right? Well, you got
you know
farmers
what's the ingredient
get high. I don't get high. I don't gamble. I don't disrespect her mother. And like, I'm like, yo, Ma, yeah, I'm doing the wrong thing. I drink too much Diet Pepsi, Diet Snapple, you name them, right? That's my problem. But other than that,
you're good.
I watch everything. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I told her you could have had a dad that was coming in here, have a problem. Always, I'm not like that.
No, you're right.
Yeah, you're right.
I don't get high. I don't do all that. I don't disrespect your mother. We never argue. Like, what are you? Like, let me drink my Diet Pepsis and Diet.
But listen, if you want to drink your Pepsi or your Sprite, you're better off than having a real one. You know why? There's an ingredient in diet. If you look on the can, look it up. It's called aspartame.
Aspartame. I know all about it. I'm wrong. I know.
He's on it. He knows.
I know what the aspartame is, but I love it. I'm an aspartame freak. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm fucked up.
We all have our vices. We all have our vices.
You know what? Just because of you guys, we're gonna have Vegan Monday.
Oh, there we go. That'd be awesome.
Just, and we're gonna go for it.
Can I say something?
Yes.
Huge fan. Your last album.
She really is.
Big Splash, my favorite song.
You know, COVID
like messed up. Right now, talking to you, so happy, she's so giddy.
We was going to shoot a big video for Big Splash, Remy, Dre. Man.
I love that song.
COVID
gets me going.
Fucked it up.
It gets me going. That song is hard.
Big Splash, shut them down. Hey, yo, we really the real in the Zion era. Wow.
And Blato Plomo, too. The album was amazing as well.
Thank you.
You know, amazing.
I appreciate you.
I appreciate you.
Thank you and the fans for always supporting me.
Joe, you're taking a break. You're taking a break.
It's a big break. Because everybody, shout out to K Slay. Shout out to everybody selling me records. UFO Thief. He's my artist. I done did 10,000 records with him. He's getting, sent me a new one today. I said, yo, Fever, I ain't been in the studio. I'm not going to the studio. I don't feel it.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep it real.
Till you feel it. If you feel it.
If I feel it, then we're going to turn up again.
I mean, you've done enough work anyways.
I'm better than all these guys.
You're killing it. You're killing it.
We're the biggest in the game, baby.
I can't wait. I can't wait to see you on TV. That'll be awesome.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. God bless. All right, my brother, stay up.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Man, that was a good one. We got something positive out of that one. Vegan Mondays. And you don't know who I know. I am Will Castro. He is not here. I am Will Castro is nowhere. Yo, he's not here, bro. So I'll get him another time. Now I can't request Will. He got to come up. He watches every day.
Obviously, my screen's black like it always is when someone adds me. I wasn't expected to be added. I was peeping out the background. I just took a shot. I have one more shot. I didn't mean to be hot at the chicken spot. 9-9, you know the 6? Shit, I almost tossed my bottle. We don't know the licks. Cartel, they be talking about the net and the flicks. Black web, get me out of...
Yeah, I know. You got your maniacs. Now that bitch was fried.
Whatever the fuck that was.
Yo, T-Bang, what the fuck? She had that hydrochloric song.
Oh.
She had that hydrochloroquine on steroids. Yo, hey, T-Bang.
What's poppin', bro?
T-Pain, living legend. I remember one time I was nominated for a Grammy and you was nominated maybe for like 7. And when you go to the Grammys, they got this room set up where you just go and you do different interviews.
Oh, the junket. Yeah, the press junket.
The junket. And you went before me. And I believe it was Kobe Cope. Somebody was interviewing you. And they was like, yo, you got like 14 number ones in a row. You competing with... the Beatles, and I was like eavesdropping, like, holy shit. Fuck. T-Pain got some fucking hits.
I had some things, you know. Some public, yo, some hidden away. I had some things. I appreciate it, though, man, you know.
What a great versus battle between you and Lil Jon.
Yeah.
I think y'all set the tone for how they say celebration now.
I think so, man. I think that was a big part of it because, like I always tell people, me and Lil Jon do that already anyways. Anytime, for some reason, people always book us together. We always at the same parties. We always overseas in the same place, same casinos. We always in it. So anytime we get together and we're like, I got a DJ set here. Shit, I'm going to come to yours. We can just play records back and forth. All right, I'll come to yours. We'll play records back. It's the same. Like, we always do that anyway. So it's always been a celebration for us. And, you know, it's never been about a competition. I don't think it really should be ever anyway. So, you know, this is all about, you know, two friends going against, you know, not going against each other, but two friends going against the grain and showing how much they've won and celebrating life. And, like, they won. Like, you know, and you get these people that's always like, well, he ain't had a hit since, or this just been this long. I mean, we've had hits though. That's an accomplishment of life.
Well,
some people would die to be associated to be in the room while a hit was being made. More so, have 15 of them in 2 years. Like no, like that's, you know, I did. So it was a celebration.
Let me explain to you, T-Pain. First of all, it is better to be a one-hit wonder than to never have a hit at all.
Absolutely.
Which you're not.
No, I get it. Trust me. So, I'd rather.
So,
I'd
so, rather.
I'd rather I'm the first. I'm the furthest from it. I'd rather have fell off than to not ever been on. So this is
T-Pain. I don't want to get you in trouble. Do you? No, I don't want to ask you that question. Nah, it's too much.
That must have been a banger, because you never.
Nah, that was a banger. You never did that.
That was a banger. That's crazy. No,
we ain't about that one, but you know, it was crazy. T-Pain, one day you came. You remember when you had the coffin? You had a hearse, right?
I had a hearse. Yeah.
And you would pull up. It got the sound system and everything, but it was a hearse. What made you?
I mean, what else could you get that you could fit 8 12? You fit 8 12s in it. Put a coffin in there. The coffin, when they opened up the lid of the coffin, got 4 TVs on it. Like, there was nothing else. I put a skeleton in there, dressed up like me, with a big ass chain and a top hat. Like, what else can you flex with? When you park the car, the coffin pops out on its own. The door opens up and the coffin slides out by itself. What else can you flex like that with? There's no other vehicle that's like, yeah, that seems like something you would do that with.
You have such an imagination. You are so creative. I'll tell you my most famous T-Pain story.
Oh, man.
This is a joke for a moment, guys. First of all, T-Pain, you made so much money, you didn't even know what money was. It's disgusting, and we could tell you was buying million-dollar top hats and shit like that. When I tell you that one day I'm in a hit factory, I don't know if you remember this, and you pull up in the Lamborghini, and the door opens, and you stepped out with aluminum for you, on your feet as your sneakers with rubber bands wrapped. This is when I knew you ain't give a fuck.
Okay, see.
Nah.
Okay, see, that was a foot treatment.
T-Pain, you look at the new Lamborghini, the door rises up, and you stepped out in aluminum. Real aluminum for you.
Well, I wanted to get to the studio, but my foot treatment wasn't done, and I needed to get in there.
T-Pain, I've never seen no shit like that. I said, this guy's, he's out of control.
Yeah, nobody, I don't know if there's like a dress code when you're driving an expensive car. Nobody liked that I took the Bugatti to Walmart all the time, and I always hopped out in like pajamas and shit. Like, nobody liked that, but people used to hate when I did that shit. You supposed to have on a suit or some shit when you're driving an expensive car? You pay for it. You can wear whatever you want in there. So, you know, sometimes while your feet going and the girls say, look, just leave this on there for 3 hours. And you're like, look, I'd be at the studio in 20 minutes. So like, I don't think you're going anywhere. So I absolutely think I am.
Yo, T-Pain, let me ask you a question. Do you miss Nuvo, the alcohol?
You know what's crazy, Joe? I can't smell it anymore. If I smell it, I throw up. I've had, like, it's like the connotation, I've thrown it up so much that when I smell it, all I can think about is throwing it up. Like, it fucked up my bodyguard crazy. My bodyguard was drinking on the tour bus one night, and he was drinking a bunch of the shit, and it was carbonated. Remember, it was carbonated, and he laid down right after he drank the shit. The shit, like, fried his vocal cords, and he never sounded the same again. The shit, like, he laid down, and the Nuvo just, like, sat on his vocal cords all night, all through the night, the bus just rocking it back and forth, carbonated drinking and shit. Bro, he's never sounded the same ever again. He's never been able to yell again. Like, he's, you know, he sound like, DMC.
Wow, for real?
Yeah.
Off the Nuvo.
Off the Nuvo, that shit sat on his vocal. He never sounded the same again. But now I can't even smell it, Joe. I'm telling you, I smell it, not throw it. Huh?
How did you come about making this All I Do Is Win, the greatest hip hop anthem ever? All I do is win. How? I know you made a lot of hits with Ross, a lot of hits with Khaled, yeah. But How did this come about? I'm mad that I wasn't actually there. I wasn't present.
Well, Khaled came in like a goddamn wrecking ball, boy. He came in that studio just ready to go. Yo, what you want to eat? I got this beat. I want you to just get on this beat. And I'm doing the shit. But, you know, Khaled is in there like, yo, I'm so tired of losing, man. I just want to win. I'm going to make sure for the next 10 years, 20 years, all I'm going to do is win for the next 20 years. And I'm like, that's okay. You just straight up wrote that song. So I go in there, I go in the booth, and I start doing my ad-libs first. Because I don't really know what I'm going to say as the actual hook. So I go in there, and I'm like, okay, what? Enough. Building. And I'm just thinking, and he's like, nah, that's not it. That's not it. And I'm like, Khaled, one, you don't know what I'm doing. Two, get the fuck out of here for about 2 hours and come back. So I had to, like, Khaled was just every step of the way. Anytime I made a noise on the microphone, Khaled was like, I don't feel it. That's not it. That's not it. Nah. Let's go another way. Let's go another way. I'm like, Khaled, let me do this. Trust me. Stop talking. Get out of here. And he left. And when he came back, he had all I do was win. And
wow.
He lost his mind. I don't know what happened after that. By that time, I was drunk.
I know what happened.
He had left all that,
that
lobster in there. I went straight to the strip club.
Number one for about 100 million weeks. Every I act like it's my record. I'm performing at my show. Whenever I get to a concert and you there, I'm like, fuck.
Yeah.
I want to do all I do is win, but you got it.
It's reserved. Seats taken.
That might be the biggest song ever.
Oof.
In the history of hip hop music.
Yeah, I might have made another We Are the Champions. Like, that's going forever be a sports driven song. Yeah. That's forever going to have placements. I'm still getting checks. It has not stopped.
That is big forever.
That's, yeah, forever, that's forever. Crazy. Yeah.
I'm sprung. What motivated you?
Well, I'll tell you what, I wrote that song for Akon, actually, because I was signed to Convict as a writer before I was signed as an artist. So
let me ask you a question, because Akon came in here, mm-hmm. and he said he took your music to Universal. You heard that story, and I seen you comment, and you said, that's cap.
Well, that because he said that I was trying to rap, and he made me sing. When he found me, I was the only person singing on a mixtape full of rappers. Keep in mind, Akon's first time hearing me was when I did a remix of Locked Up, which I call Fucked Up. Because I called it Fucked Up. That's what I'm talking about. And that's what I'm talking. So when I did that, that's when everybody started hearing me. And that's when people started hearing Akon like, bro, it's this little dude, this little singer dude. Blah, blah, blah. So he didn't. He was saying that he stopped me from singing. He stopped me from rapping and had me start singing. I was already singing when Akon met me. That was the cap part. No big deal.
No big deal, huh?
No big deal. But I was already singing because I was doing all the hooks for my rap group that I was in, and I was the only motherfucker in that singing for real.
Yo, so how did you get on? Because you from Tallahassee.
Yeah. It was that song. It was we already had like some fame as the Nappy Heads. There was just a bunch of niggas with dreads. I think it was seven of us. We all had dreads. We was big in like a tri-state area, kind of up a little bit bigger than that. But, you know, we already had a little fame. So the first thing that people would call me is like the little dude, the youngest one from the Nappy Heads, like little dude from the Nappy Heads. And I was making all the beats. I was doing all the hooks. And it was always, I'm the little dude from the Nappy Heads. So once I broke off into T-Pain, then, you know, we started doing our mixtape together. Everybody started doing their solo albums. And I did my solo album. And then mine got a little more noticed because I was singing and everybody else was rapping. So, you know, and everybody in Tallahassee was rapping and it wasn't that many singers there. So it was really a every man for himself kind of thing in Tallahassee. And the singing got more noticed than the rapping because everybody wants to be a rapper, obviously. So the singing just caught more attention. And once I made the Locked Up remix, that's when Akon came through and like, all right, you kind of remind me of me. I'm gonna take you on my way and do a joint.
T-Pain, and you can answer it. Don't want to answer it, whatever, because I'm not with the bullshit. But it's just something that it just keeps pounding my brain. When Jay-Z went at you, did you have any other any reason for any type of reason, or that was out the clear blue sky?
That was when I heard it, and when motherfuckers was calling me, telling me about it. I literally had to sit for like a day in the same position. I just sat and just stared into nothing. Like, the fuck did I do? What did I do? Did I cross somebody? I don't fight like that. Did I mistakenly beat somebody up in my sleep? What? Who did that? Does he fuck with somebody I don't like? Like, who? What happened? I don't know what happened.
You didn't know what it was.
No, my hustle got knocked. Immediately, like, I don't know what I did. Like, I'm like, what is the guys? There has to be some kind of connection to something I've done that can make this man say the very thing that made this guy famous is the worst shit ever. Like, I'm trying to figure out what the fuck did I do, and I couldn't. There's nothing before. I had never, no way. Like, think about it, bro. The timeline, I had not been famous enough, I had not done anything big enough to even get close to anybody next to Jay. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's nothing I could have done to trigger that. And I think it was getting kind of powerful, and that's not a good position for somebody. And, you know, it started a whole nother genre of music. It was a powerful thing. And you got the commissioner of what is cool. You got the number one person in hip hop that says what's cool and what y'all niggas need to like and what y'all niggas need to dislike.
Well, it's similar to Bone Thugs. So when Bone Thugs came out and their flow was crazy, some people ain't understand what they was doing. And then Mariah Carey, all of R&B stole that flow and ran with it. And so like you were the first to really, really blow with the. Not the first ever, because you got Roger.
Yeah, not Zapp. Not at all.
You got Zapp, Roger Zapp, and them
computers. Yeah, Cher was the most. Cher was the biggest out of, you know what I'm saying? Cher had a whole song of it, the Believe joint.
Yeah. So it's been used in the past, but you reemerged it and you was winning. But now, if you ain't got auto-tune, you ain't popping.
You're not. You're just not. It's a weird thing. It's a weird thing. I have no idea what triggered that, bro. I still, to this day, don't know. And you know, I got a lot of people that hit me, you know, people of your stature, people that's around, dude, that's like, I don't know what happened.
I think that was just the competitive, now that you broke it down to me, I think it was just competitive in the hip-hop with him. I'll ask him. I very much...
Hey,
shout out to Prince Marky D in the comments. Woo! From the Fat Boy, living legend.
Yeah.
God bless you, Marky D, boy, wow. Living legend.
Jesus.
Hey, yo, T-Pain, man. I remember you. I keep thinking of this one, too. You don't hang out with the little girl no more, huh?
Who?
The little girl.
You gotta be specific in these times, man. It's 2020.
I can't be. Forget it. Yeah, wait.
Now you gotta do it. Now you gotta say it because
it was during the circus thing. I used to see you with little girl. not a little baby, not a girl.
A short person. No, all my little people got some
We love the little people, guys. But yo, DJ Nasty.
Little people. Actual little people.
not a little girl. Not
little people, everybody. It's we talking about little
with not being disrespectful. And I thought T-Pain had the hots for her.
That was about a damn show, man. We had to do that shit with the Britney Spears. Because she's a Britney Spears impersonator. So I brought her out because Britney Spears was doing her circus tour the same time I was doing my Three Rings tour. So we just had to flip that around and make it look like I was making fun of Britney Spears. But it was, they got like Vegas shows now. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like they're doing craziness. They doing.
T-Pain, what's the most money you spent on like
an outfit and a hat? Ooh, that's a Terrell question.
Never mind, he's here. Right,
yeah, that's a Terrell Jones question.
No, I'm not going to ask Terrell a shot. Nah, hold up. Those are the good old days, right, Terrell? That boy T-Pain, you had every hat in the game.
Yeah, we still got him, man. It's the whole
Yo, let me tell you something. One of my favorite videos ever. You had the hat open and turned into like a Ferris wheel.
Oh, yeah.
What video, what song was that?
That was Can't Believe It.
Ooh, can't believe it?
Let's see how we rolling now.
Yo, that video is so old. There go the hats.
So that's like now. Yeah.
Yo.
You know?
Can't believe it. Can't believe it was so crazy, boy. That video, one of my favorite videos ever in the history of hip hop.
Just got this done. You got to get this in the crib. Just got the ceiling done. You got to get this in the Michael Jackson
upside down.
You got to get this in the crib. We lit up. You got to get this going. You know what I'm saying? We're trying to work, man. We're doing something special. You know, special things. We'll figure it out.
Man, let me tell you something. You are the man. Thank you for coming on the show.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me, bro.
We love you, my brother. You are a living legend. You are number one songwriter in the world. So many hits. I can't even name. I love when you work with Ross. I'm going to end it on that one because I can keep talking to you forever.
We need more of those. We need to get back on it too, man. So, you know, whenever you're ready. Man.
I got too much love. I'll get to you through Terrell.
I'm going to remind you of something. You still ain't did the mask song.
What mask song?
The ski mask song. You know what fucking song I'm talking about? We supposed to did that years ago. You still ain't did the ski.
You know I'm fried.
I got you. I'm going to remind you. Fried. I'm going to give you some more details.
Break him out.
It's not a good platform.
And also, I need a song. I have a female artist. Her album's actually coming out Friday or Thursday at midnight, tomorrow night at midnight. Her name is Angelica Villa on Rock Nation, and she's fire.
Big
I need you to write one for her because I know you
write. I'm available. I'm not going anywhere. I keep doing shit to my house. Please give me something to do so I can stop doing all this shit to my house.
Hey, yo, we love you, T-Pain, man.
Thank you so much
for the love.
Let's get it. Thank you,
nice
bro.
Nice hat.
Yes.
Yo, that boy. You don't know who I know. You don't know who I know. Let me be honest with you. Today I was supposed to have Tyrese. Something came up. Could have came at 9. I bullshitted you and winged the whole shit. And it turned into a movie. You got a little T-Pain. We talked with Dre. We talked with everybody, and we still looking for Will Casho. We're going to have to do this shit tomorrow. Rasha Bel Hassan. Salam alaikum, my brother out there in Dubai. Much love. Let me tell you something. Put God first. Respect the COVID. Shout out Ruben Diaz Jr., Bronx Borough President. Respect the COVID. I'm riding through Harlem, the Bronx, Washington Heights. A lot of guys walking around no mask. Please, if not for yourself, for others. Please take it serious. I'm begging you guys. OG Andy Boy is on here, AKA the Funny Shape Teepin. Once again, OG Andy Boy, King of Logos, is on here, AKA the Funny Shape Teepin. Happy birthday, my brother, Raul. God bless you, Raul. We love you, Raul. Raul, I can't pay you for your loyalty. I can't pay you for being who you are. Being one of my top five friends, I'm almost ready to say top three. You have been one of the most loyal people I have ever met in my life. And I love you. Raul Conde. Put God first, everybody. Tomorrow night, I'm going to do something really, really special for you guys. My artist, pre-order it. Angelica Villa on Rock Nation, RNG. Her album is phenomenal. Deception Season 1. Nobody's hotter. Hitmaker, you're scared of me. Don't come in here with the eyes lurking if you don't want to talk your shit. I never seen a guy so successful. So many hit records don't want to come on the Fat Joe show. Everybody comes on the Fat Joe show. T.S., we incredibly credible. Mafio, te quiero mucho, mi hermano. Success Global. You know, we got them all. Mi gente Latino, por favor, cuídase. And COVID, oh shit, I didn't know that. You saying that. You've been hiding from me. I'm on that live, Breon. I'm on that live, Breon.
The big show. The big show. Wow.
Baker. The big, 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 big show.
Wow.
Yo, let me tell you something, brother.
Please, please
you
do.
You are the biggest in the game. I'll put you up against anybody. Richie Akiva. Butter.
Brother, they scared of me in Versus. I don't know who's going to try and see me. I don't know what's going to happen. But
I think you're talking shit, Hitmaker. I think you're talking shit. I agree with you. I'm going to be there
for
you.
Cool.
I'm going to get in trouble. Let me tell you something. Yo, Breon. Hold up. Yo, let me tell you something. I'm going to get beat up in New Orleans because of Scott Storch. When my people, you my people, you under my umbrella, when my people go in that Versus, I go bad on them comments. Bad. So whoever you go against, it's over. Slaughterhouse.
Who can?
The problem is, I think you're talking shit.
No, I'm fully with you. My brother, my brother. You know I don't leave here, my brother. I'm here. Like, it's over. The rest of the, cancel the rest of the year for all your favorite producers. Cancel it. We run the rest of the year. We already in 2021, Joe. Like, we not wasting no time on these people. The records that we created last year, the records that are coming out now, what we create this year, what they'll receive in 2021.
Let me tell you something. I'm so proud of you, why you never gave up. And they try to stereotype people. They try to, you know, when I first started, you know, I was such a street dude. When I went to get a deal for Pun, they told Steve Rifkin, yo, don't mess with him. This guy's an extraordinary. He's a crook. He's a gangster. He's a this. Steve Rifkin told me it turned him on. He loves gangsters. But you, they spread rumors about you. You know, yo, this young bird. And you never gave up. And
never.
You are so successful. And you outworked everybody. You outworked everybody. In the COVID, you was calling me, Joe, from the studio. I said, fuck no.
That nigga, yo, you told me no fucking way.
Yo, my brother ain't pulling up. I said, hell no. Things done changed.
Bro. I'm fully loaded. Whenever, well, sidebar, whenever you decide to come out from the Joper show, guess who's fully loaded? Guess who? We're on the ad. Like, as soon as you come out, like, it's
yo,
not.
Yo, listen. Who you produced for recently?
Man, Meg Thee Stallion. We got some new joints on the way. Executive producing French Montana album that we got some joints on the way. Man, the whole game. Look at my Instagram. Every Friday, it's a new release.
Yo, let me tell you something. That's and that's a testament to you working so hard. You work harder than everybody. I seen it,
bro.
I seen it. You work harder than everybody, and you're a fucking hit maker. You know what you're doing. You make hits. You don't play with these people.
Yeah, you told the story when I came to Kool & Dre Studio and we was doing Yes, and I came in, I pulled up in a Rolls Royce, and I fell in your studio. I was on Miami time for real. I was super faded. Brought my engineer in.
You was the most high I ever seen a human being. And you dropping the 1942. You spilling it. Like, you're almost trying to mess up the studio. Like, so my man, I'm going to tell you the truth. My man Smitty come to me, Smitty Beats.
Mm-hmm.
He pulled me over. He said, yo, God, can I talk to you? I said, yeah. So I go outside. He said, yo, man, this guy, we're going to have to throw him out the studio. He's throwing him all over the shit. I said, you leave that motherfucker right where he's at. This is how he works. This is how the hits come. You leave that motherfucker right where he's at.
It's Miami.
Came up with that, yes.
Bro, I remember we flipped it in like that was a crazy, legendary night. Like, yo, like, and it turned into that.
Let me tell you something. That song did big numbers. It's just a real Latin America. A lot of spins and views and all that came from Latin America. So when they come from Latin America, you can't count that in America. Otherwise, it would have been platinum a long time ago. These are facts. You can ask Gazi, call him. The shit did the platinum numbers. It's just America don't count it when it comes from South America and all that. Know what I'm saying? But anything, my brother, let me let you go. You know I love you.
Thank you. You know I love you.
We'll talk soon. And yes, if you get in the verses, I'm going to have to fight the whole Texas.
Yo, I get in verses, I win, hands down. I'm the underdog. Line them up. Whoever. I sold 10 million on a song with Ray J. Like, calm down. I did 10 million on a song with Ray J. Relax.
The one with everybody Ray J relax. Was your first big one, right? What was
no,
it
the first big one was Sexy Lady. And that's multi. Then the next one was the one with Ray J. But that's just as Young Berg. Like, I ain't even, like, it's so many records that don't have my tag on it, Joe. Like, you gotta think
been
about
making,
like
been making all the hits.
Joe, I appreciate you. I love you, my brother. You embrace me like, yo, love you, bro.
I love you, bro.
Wow.
Hitmaker finally showed up. You don't know who I know. You don't know who I know. Yeah, he did Sexy Can I. I mean, the Hitmaker, he got way too much hits for everybody. The man's not even fair for human beings. Hey, y'all, Breon, you don't know who I know. Breon, we killing these guys. Yo, Breon, when you going to do another battle? The R&B battle. I'm waiting for the R&B battle. So Breon got the shit where he plays his favorite R&B song. It could be slow or whatever. And he battled his man. And he play a joint. Breon was winning. That homeboy took off on him. I got to see the battle. I want to do it on my show. I got to get ready, Breon. Everybody put God first because it's late. Tomorrow night, it's going to be legendary. I got my girl, Angelica Villa, drops her shit tomorrow night at 12 midnight. I need everyone to stream it. Go and do streaming parties. If you love Fat Joe, you go stream Angelica Villa. Deception Season 1. If you love Joe Crack, if you believe I'm a hit maker, if you believe that I got what it takes, you support her album. Peace, y'all. I'll talk to you, Jack.
You people are crazy.